Sir ji, if you do not reduce the rent, we will leave.
It is a big world, my friend, and everyone is free to do as he pleases. If you do not wish to pay what I ask, then take your belongings and go.
Electricity. You people want electricity. Do you think I'm some kind of magician? These days they ask 20 rupees for a simple connection.
That's exactly what you said last month and took 30 rupees from us. I think only a complaint to the rent control authorities will get us electricity.
There, there. Don't worry. We will have power by the end of the month. The contractor has given me 100% assurance.
I think when we are dead, we will get electricity.
Don't say such inauspicious things, sir. A 5 rupees bribe will solve all the problems.
I won't give a paisa more for all those crooked deals of yours.
Be reasonable. Be reasonable. All in good time. I assure you of that.
Come, father.
Old man doesn't die. Son continues to crib.
Could you tell me where the Guruji stays?
What then? You see the green door? That one? That's the house.
Don't worry, son. Once we reach the Guruji, everything is going to be all right. Come along.
Don't worry. There's nothing to be afraid of.
Come on.
Come on now.
As soon as I saw his face, I knew it. This is all his karma. No one can escape from destiny. Mahadaridra yamagyasya. Mahapapa hatasya cha. Tell me, was there an old woman in his life? Someone who was not well disposed towards him? Be frank.
Yes, there is a woman, Kamu.
She's quite old.
Even acts innocent, the witch.
Yes, that woman has bewitched your son. Do you know what that means? She has him in her control.
Guruji, what shall we do now?
Please save my son.
Don't worry. Om Kali Kai Namaha. Go away. is under my control. Listen to me. On the no moon night, go to the outskirts of the village. There, you will find a tree. Which one?
Banyan tree.
Dig under the banyan tree and bring to me any bone that you may find. That'll be 25 rupees. I will bless the bone and throw it into the Sariu River. Only then will your son be safe for a while.
Sethji,
what is it?
Why have you kept these tins here today?
There have been a spate of robberies around Malgudi these days. If those dacoits dare to come here, then these tins will topple down at the slightest contact. It's an intricate burglar alarm. Not for simpletons like you. Close the doors. And report early tomorrow.
Yes, sir.
Get in. I don't know. Stop shouting and open the door.
All right.
So, Sedji, where are all those thieves you have been yelling about?
No thieves, Guruji. Only rats.
Now you know what Sedji hoards in his shop. Rats!
Hey, shut up, you ungrateful people! Do you know I lose 10 kilos of grain to these rats every month?
Hey! Calm down, Sedji, calm down. When the cat is away, the mice are bound to rule. Listen to some holy advice and get a cat home. There's no dearth of cats in Malgudi.
Heard that? Get a cat soon, Sedji.
Go away. Go to your house. Go.
Come on, out. Father.
Sedji.
What is it?
Meow.
Just show you.
Get a cat, he says. I'm not going to keep the door locked. We'll see. Get a cat. As if it's his grandfather's property.
Namaste, Sedji.
Namaste.
Sedji.
What do you want now?
I need a job.
See me tomorrow.
Huh. Namaste, Sedji.
Namaste. So you're working here now?
Hmm.
Is this my lord?
Yes.
Is the owner inside?
Yes, sir.
Don't you argue with me. This is all I will give you, not a penny more. Ah, Sedji, come. I was just loading your order. Here is your list. Won't you sit down? Please, come. How much do you charge for all this in Malgudi, Sedji? You must be making good money, eh?
It's none of your business. What's your bill?
140 rupees.
Your brother-in-law stayed with me for a month, remember?
Yes, so?
Deduct 40 rupees as rent.
40 rupees?
Yes. He had breakfast and tea with me for 30 days.
But 40 rupees...
Listen, I didn't ask you to send him to Malgudi or my place. I gave him a roof over his head when he needed it. So don't bargain with me.
Sir, the cart is loaded.
I'll see you next month.
You want some, sir?
How much is that, Bandar?
You do all the dealing with me, okay? How much you take two bundles, sir?
Bundles, sir? I don't think I need.
Oh, Guruji, you are our only hope. You are the only one who can cure him. We've heard of your successful practice from so many sources and have come from Pondicherry.
People have journeyed here from as far as Singapore and Hong Kong. Karma has brought you here. Events of your past life. Close your eyes. Pick a leaf. I knew it. He is possessed by the ancient spirit Pumbaria. Throw the nail of a horse into the fire under the auspices of the constellation Scorpio. Only then will the spirit leave. That will be 108 rupees. There is a slight problem. During the Scorpio constellation, you may not find a horse. If you find a horse, there may be no nail. If you procure them both, there may be no constellation. But don't you worry. Solutions can always be. Hey, you! Get out! Get out! Get out! Don't you worry. Solutions can always be found. Come back again. Place 504 rupees on the feet of Goddess Kali. Horse, nail, and the constellation will all come automatically.
Namaskar, Guru.
What is it?
Bone.
Bone?
Bone.
The bone. Come with me.
Hey.
Look at that board. He has again raised the price of kerosene. He used to sell it at 1 rupee 30 paisa.
This set is born to loot us.
Look, I can't sell it cheaper than the rate at which I buy it, can I?
You won't prosper, Sedji. You won't prosper.
You there. Pay up last month's rent, then talk about prosperity.
Talks about prosperity.
Look at Venkatesh.
Yes, Sedji.
Close the door. Come early tomorrow.
Okay, Sedji.
No, don't lock it. I'll just latch it.
Pujari ji, here is Bapuji. There is a vessel. A strange creature seems to be in it. I don't know what it is bouncing around. It may be a ghost, maybe a spirit.
It is some devilish creature. Impossible to describe that thing.
That Sedji is a devil. God knows what he's been up to these days.
Ghost, I knew it.
You people know everything. Wake up the exorcist. It's a matter for him to handle.
The exorcist went to sleep early today. He had a hard day's work. 3 customers.
Imbeciles, clear the way.
Guruji! Guruji! Marappa! Marappa!
Marappa! Marappa! What is it?
Guruji, strange things are going on at my place. Will you please come with me? I need your help.
All right. I'll get ready and come.
Such strange things, Guruji. It's difficult to describe. It's very frightening. Come, sir.
Don't you worry. My powers reach beyond this world. Now tell me, what is happening here?
A vessel seems to come to life
and bobs up and down and hits everything around it. I can't understand it.
I see. It's the old junk spirit. In Sanskrit, it is called Ghataprit.
Ghataprit?
Yes. It always enters and animates an empty jug. That is why our ancestors have decreed that no vessel should be kept with its mouth open to the sky. Sedji, I thought you of all people would know this. Did your parents teach you anything? Quiet. Yes, it is the jug spirit. It always tries to frighten you with terrifying sounds. If you are afraid, it will break your skull.
Oh, Guruji, I have always led a clean and honest life, never harming a soul. Why should this happen to me?
Spirits never enter the jugs of good people. You must have done something wrong in your past.
What sort of things?
How should I? Take the child away. Sedji, this is a mischievous jug spirit. But weak-minded people are bound to be afraid of it. Yes. And may even vomit blood. But I can deal with it.
As you say, Guruji.
If we had electric lights, we could at least have switched them on and seen that creature.
Every corner of this town has electric lights. We alone have to suffer in darkness. Mm. Only a single lavatory for 20 families?
A single well, too.
All in good time. All in good time, sirs. This is no occasion for complaints.
No kerosene for 3 days, sir. He sells it at 3 rupees a liter and says I haven't harmed a soul.
Why don't you clear out if you're so unhappy? I don't need nagging tenants like you.
I say, Sedji, quiet. Look, I am also a tenant, but I don't make complaints now. All in proper time. This evil spirit has to be driven out. And it emerges. No one must stand in its way. Otherwise, it will get under your skin.
Never mind. It won't be worse than our landlord. I would love to take this devil under my skin and kick these walls.
That wouldn't help. The walls are very weak. When I lie in bed with my wife, even the littlest whisper is heard on all sides.
But you're not married.
What if? There are others with families.
All right, all right. Come on, Sedji. You must be having a torch.
Torch?
Perhaps a lantern?
No, kerosene.
At least a candle?
Candle?
I say it is understandable you don't provide electricity to your tenants. But what sort of a shopman are you without candles in your shop?
Candles are in a box on the right-hand side, on the shelf as you step in.
You want me to step in there? In the darkness yonder where the evil spirit dwells? All right. But I'll charge a special fee for approaching the spirit. Otherwise, I always work from a distance.
I'll pay whatever you demand, Guruji. But please go inside and drive the devil away.
All right. Hey, jug spirit, Ghataprit, I am not afraid of you. I know your kind too well, and you know me well. Go away, go away, go away. No ordinary spirit. It seizes me like a tornado. It will break down the walls. If you're not quick enough, it will ruin us. I need some more protection.
Guruji, then what will happen to my shop, my property?
Don't worry, we will manage. Now you go and get me a copper bowl, a copper tumbler, and a copper spoon, and some camphor. Go.
Why copper, Guruji?
Don't ask me questions. All right, I'll tell you. Because it is a good conductor. I need a good medium to lead my mantras to that horrible thing.
Guruji, I don't have copper, only aluminium.
In our country, even the poorest of poor would have a copper pot. And here you are,
calling yourself a landlord, and you have nothing. No candles, no lights, no carpa. All right, let me try.
Guruji, please don't break the vessel. Guruji!
Don't speak loudly. Don't even breathe. I'm getting signals. I am asked to say that it is the spirit of someone who is seeking redress. Did you wrong someone in your life?
No. I have always been charitable.
Don't tell me anything. Talk to yourself and to that spirit inside. Did you at any time? Wait a minute. Did you at any time handle someone else's wife or money?
Oh, no, never.
Then what is it I hear about your holding a trust for a widow?
Trust? What trust? God has given me enough to live on.
Don't talk unnecessarily. Did you ever molest a helpless woman or keep her at your mercy? If you have done a wrong in your childhood, you could expiate.
How?
That I will explain. First, confess.
Why?
A true repentance on your part will emasculate the evil spirit.
Please stop that somehow. I can't bear it.
All right. Give that camphor. A match. To propitiate the benign spirits so that they may come to our aid. Om. Get back. Your conscience should be clear like Manasaro Lake. So repeat after me whatever I say. If you try to do any cheating, the evil spirit will not hesitate to break your skull. Repeat. I have always lived a good and honest life.
I have always lived a good and honest life.
Never cheated anyone.
Cheated anyone.
Never misappropriated anyone's property.
Which property do you mean?
I don't know. I hear of some irregularity.
It's not my mistake. The property came into my hands. That's all, Guruji.
Whom did it belong to?
Honappa, my friend and neighbor. We cultivated adjoining fields. He wrote a will.
In your favor?
Yes.
What happened then?
He was never seen again.
Was the body found?
How would I know?
What about the widow?
I protected her as long as she lived.
Under the same roof?
Not here, in the village.
Were you intimate?
Well, she had to be protected.
How did she die?
That's enough. I won't say anything more. I've already said everything possible. If you don't get the devil out after all this, you'll share the same fate. Now you come with me. Come on. Who's that? Going. So, Marappa, where is this jug spirit you are talking about? Inside the jug was only a cat.
Yes, it was only a cat inside. But what was inside the cat, Sedji?
Huh?